Mr. Butterworth. We are extremely pleased to see you back to your normal, creative and productive self in such an illustrious way. Your finished arachnid design has left all who have seen it here at the Guild in awe of its craftsmanship and engineering. Amusingly, some of the directors have been rediscovering their inner child while reviewing your prototype. A few days ago, Guild Master Clark was inspecting the stitching on a new line of teddy bears, and as a joke, Master Osborne placed an arachnid on the floor behind him. The arachnid swiftly powered itself on, crawled on Master Clark's leg, sprung on the workbench, and proceeded to rip the teddy bear in pieces. I haven't seen Master Osborne laugh so hard in years. Speaking of the arachnid's ability to keep themselves powered for so long, many of the masters have expressed a deep fascination with that particular feature. Master Rook, our head of engineering, has locked himself in his workshop, trying to deconstruct the design of your custom battery. As he claims, powering a toy so large and mobile with such a small voltaic pile should be mathematically impossible. In the meantime, the rest of the Directorate have instructed me to ensure your progress continues unencumbered. So please find attached yet more previously undisclosed schematics. During his latter years, Bartleby was conducting similar experiments around electricity and charge. He believed autonomous, self-powered toys to be the future not only for toys, but also for toy-making itself. Such machinery, he argued, would enable the Guild to automate large parts of the production process and reduce the dependency on the frequently error-prone human factor. He was a fascinating man of science, our great founder, and as a man of science yourself, we feel you will find these particular designs extremely interesting, and we can't wait to see what you do with them. Yours, Lucien Mantelfell, Secretary of the Guild of Toymakers. Many of the masters have expressed a deep fascination with that particular feature. Master Rook, our head of engineering, has locked himself in his workshop, trying to deconstruct the design of your custom battery. As he claims, powering a toy so large and mobile with such a small voltaic pile should be mathematically impossible. In the meantime, the rest of the Directorate have instructed me to ensure your progress continues unencumbered. So please find attached yet more previously undisclosed schematics. During his latter years, Bartleby was conducting similar experiments around electricity and charge. He believed autonomous, self-powered toys to be the future not only for toys, but also for toy-making itself. Such machinery, he argued, would enable the Guild to automate large parts of the production process and reduce the dependency on the frequently error-prone human factor. He was a fascinating man of science, our great founder, and as a man of science yourself, we feel you will find these particular designs extremely interesting, and we can't wait to see what you do with them. Yours, Lucien Mantelfell, Secretary of the Guild of Toymakers.
Thank you.